All right, guys. So our job today is we're going to learn how to add vectors together. So up until now, we've done a lot of conceptual work. Now we're actually going to work with the math of it. And I'm going to go through the game plan first, then we'll talk about how to actually do it. But the idea is you're going to start with a couple of vectors. And remember, vectors have magnitude and direction. So you're going to take your vectors. First thing we're going to do with them is we're going to break them down into pieces. We're going to bust them up into what's called components. And then we're going to add the pieces together, and then we're going to rebuild and get back to the final answer. So this is going to be a process of taking something, breaking it down into the pieces, and then rebuilding it. So first of all, the idea of adding vectors, you're going to place your vectors tail to tail. So if we've got a couple of vectors, we're going to place them so that they are tail to tail. So here's one vector, and here's another vector. And they are not tail to tail right now. By the way, the tail of the vector is this little bottom part, and the head of the vector is the pointy part. So I'm going to talk about the tail of the vector. It's the non-pointy part. If you take this vector and you grab it and you move it over here so that it is touching the tail of the other vector, those two vectors are tail to tail. And the thing about vectors is you can move them wherever you want to. As long as you keep them pointing the same direction and you keep them the same size, you can move them all over the place. So step number one is place the vectors tail to tail. Yes. We're going to call the point where they are tail to tail. That's going to be our point O or point zero. So right there is the point O. All right, next step, we're going to finish off the parallelogram. And if you look at my two vectors right now, they look like two sides of a rectangle. A rectangle is a parallelogram. So we're going to finish that off, make our little parallelogram here. The vector sum is the diagonal of that parallelogram, starting from our point O. So if you go from point O across the diagonal like this, that green arrow represents the vector sum of those two original vectors. Now that works pretty well, and if you think about it, if I need a number to go along with this vector sum, let's say that I knew that this red arrow was 4 newtons, and I knew that the blue one was 3 newtons, how could I figure out the magnitude of that green arrow? Do what to them? Add them together. But they're not lined up. They're not parallel to each other. There you go, Pythagorean theorem. So the nice thing about my two vectors being perpendicular to each other is to figure out what the magnitude of this is. We can do Pythagorean theorem. But in order for Pythagorean theorem to work, my two original vectors have got to be perpendicular to each other. And they aren't always. But that idea is going to help us, because if we can get things to be perpendicular to each other, then we know that we've got Pythagorean theorem, and we can pull that out of the toolbox and work with that. Okay. All right, so here's a couple of vectors that are not parallel to each other. So here's vector number one. Here's vector number two. That basic idea of finishing off the parallelogram. So we go do, 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 do. Okay, finishing off the parallelogram. The vector sum is still that diagonal. That still works. And honestly, if you draw everything to scale, like if I decided, oh, this is really 3 newtons, I'm going to make a centimeter be a newton, and draw everything to scale and measure the angles and make my parallelogram perfectly, and I can measure that diagonal across here, I could actually figure out what that vector sum would be. But that is really tedious. You have to be really, really careful. And there's another way to do it. You can do it with mathematics instead of doing it by scaling. But honestly, the scaling does work. All right, so to work with numerical solution, we need to work with right angles. And in order to get everything to right angles, we're going to do something called the components of vectors. And this is the breaking down business that we talked about. So we know if we can get everything to be at right angles to each other, it'll work. We're going to break everything down so that we get everything to be at right angles. And that'll make it so that we can use our Pythagorean theorem. And we can also use the basic trig functions. You guys know the basic trig functions? Sine, cosine, and tangent. We can use those, and that'll help us so that we can get numbers. I'll leave it there for a second. I'll post this up for you guys. So. You have to take a second and figure out how to spell Pythagorean. Pythagorean's easier to spell than theorem is, I think. All right, so vectors. Remember, what makes a vector is a vector has magnitude. That's its size. That's its number amount. And when you draw it out, it's represented by the length. Although if you're going to do it mathematically, you can just write its number next to it, not have to worry so much about getting the length perfect. But you ought to make bigger vectors longer and smaller vectors shorter. They also have direction. So vectors have magnitude and they have direction. To work with two-dimensional vectors, we're going to end up splitting them into what's called X and Y components. Now, the 2D business. When we did kinematics, everything was in a straight line. That's one dimension. We had vectors when we did kinematics, but they were all parallel to each other. So we did simple mathematics. You can just add and subtract. That's all you had to do. But now we're going to have things that are not all in a straight line. We're going to have things in two dimensions. And we're going to break things into X and Y components. So, if this is my original vector, R, right here, I'm going to break it apart into components. And you want to think about having an X and Y axis. So, just our classic X axis and Y axis. So I'm going to go backwards now. I just showed you how to take two vectors and add them together. Now we're going to take a vector and break it apart. We're going to break it apart into two vectors that are perpendicular to each other. So I'm going to have a component on the x-axis. It's going to be right here. Component on the y-axis. It's going to be right there. And remember what we just did. If you finish up the parallelogram, the sum of these two vectors, x component and the y component, the sum of those is that diagonal. So now I'm starting with the sum and breaking it apart. So it's like if it was useful, thank you.